Hello students, welcome to the session of division of decimal numbers. This is actually exercise 2.7 continuation only. Now we are going to divide a whole number using a decimal number. Division of a whole number by a decimal number. Fifth problem, find first subdivision 7 divided by 3.5. Actually numerator value is whole number, denominator value is 3.5. How can we write this? 7 divided by 3.5. Ignoring the decimal point first, that is very simple. How can we ignore the decimal point here? Normally, we divide a decimal number using a decimal number means easily we have to ignore a decimal point. Now, denominator only we have a decimal point. So, we have to check the digit values. How many digit values after the decimal point we are having? Only one place. So, we have to choose a value 10. Numerator same value. Using the 10 value, now we are going to multiply and divide the numerator value. That time only we have to omit the decimal point. Okay, so 3.5 into 10 by 10. Using the 10,000, we just multiply the values. Now that point, the decimal point, move towards right. Suppose we have to using the decimal number divide the value using 10,000. Now automatically the decimal point move towards left only. Now we multiply the decimal number using the number 10. What is the answer? 7 by 35 divided by 10. Actually this 10 also moved to numerator. Automatically it goes to numerator. So we have to write 7 into 10, 70 by 35. 35 ones are 35 twos are. So denominator value 1 is no value, no. So directly we have to take the value 2. Next problem, 36 divided by 0.2. Same, we are going to divide a whole number using a decimal number. The denominator value decimal number, one digit place only we are having after the decimal point. So again we have to choose the number 10. So same numerator value. Now we are going to multiply and divide the numerator using the value 10. Why we choose 10 means after the decimal point we have only one place, so choose the value 10. Why at a time we use the value 10 into 10 by 10 means our question is decimal number only. For our easy process only we want to remove the decimal point. So multiply using the value 10. But we can't change the question, no. So automatically we use the number 10 for division also. 0.2 into 10 by 10. For into 10 means we want to remove the decimal point. By 10 means we need the same question. That time only we have the same question 0.2. So 36 divided by 0.2 into 10. What is the value? 2. Because you multiply the value using 10 means automatically the decimal point move towards right one place. So 2 divided by 10. Now division of a whole number. Okay. And now the denominator value 10 move to numerator. So how can we write? 360 by 2. So 2 ones are 2, balance 1, 2 8s are 16, we take the value 0. So the answer is 180. Next problem, division of a decimal number using a decimal number. Okay. What is our question? 3.25 divided by 0.5. Now we have a decimal value for numerator and denominator. But numerator we have two places. After the decimal point we have two places. But denominator we have only one place value. But we can't choose for numerator 100, denominator 10. That has no meaning. So easily we have to choose for numerator also we are going to multiply using the value 100. Denominator also we are going to use the same value 100. How can we use this? We want the decimal point here, so we have to move the decimal point to place. Choose the value 100. So 3.25 into 100. We have to divide the value also using the same number. That time only we get the same question. Okay, divided by 0.5. same procedure we are going to follow, into 100 by 100. Now automatically this 100 cancel. What is our value? Numerator value 325. What is our denominator value? Actually multiply using the value 100, now we have to move two place towards right. Here we have one value, so extra we have to add 10. Okay. Now we have to cancel this number using the value 5. 5 tens are 50. 5 6 are 30. Balance to 5 5 are 25. Actually 65 by 10. Now divide the value using 10, 100, 1000. Now automatically the decimal point move towards left. So the answer is 6.5. Okay. The next problem, 30.94 divided by 0.7. Now we need a whole number, no? So we have to remove the decimal point. Numerator we have two decimal places after the decimal point, but denominator one place only. We have to choose the maximum value. Two decimal place means we have to choose the value 100. So 30.94 into 100 by 100. Okay. Divided by 0.7 into same value 100 by 100. Because this cancellation is easy, no? So I choose the same value. 100, 100 cancel. Multiplying value using the value 100 means automatically the point move towards right two places. So what is our value in the numerator? 3094. Now denominator 0.7 only into 100. Actually this decimal point move towards the right two places, but we have only one place value. We have to add extra one zero here. Okay. Now use the value 7 table, 7 4s are 28, balance 2, 29. Again 7 4s are 28, balance 1, 14. 7 2s are 14. 7 10s are 70. Actually 4 4 2 by 10. Divide the value using 10, 100, 1000 means we have to move the decimal point towards left. So the answer is 44.2. Okay. Next. 0.5 divided by 0.25. Numerator value 0.5, denominator value 0.25. Here denominator value we have two decimal place values. Numerator we have only one place values. So we have to choose the value 100. So automatically we have to multiply the numerator value also using the value 100 and divide the value using the value 100. 0.25 into 100 by 100. Cancellation is easy, so I choose the same value. 100, 100 cancel. Actually, we are going to multiply using the value 10, 100, 1000 means we have to move the decimal point towards right only. Now we have only one value, no? So we have to add extra one zero, that is 50. Divided by here, what is the value? 25. 25 ones are, 25 twos are. So the answer is 2. That's all. Next problem, a vehicle covers a distance of 43.2 km in 2.4 liters of petrol. How much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? One detail is given. We have to calculate distance travelled in 1 liter of petrol only. Okay. First, we have to take the given values. What is given? Distance travelled in 2.4 liters of petrol is equal to 43.2 kilometer. Okay, this is given. We have to calculate distance traveled in 1 liter of petrol. Actually, distance travelled in 2.4 liters of petrol, 43.2 km. We have to calculate the distance travelled in 1 liter of petrol. So, we just divide the value. 43.2 divided by 2.4. This is a division of a decimal number using a decimal number. Both value having one decimal places only after the decimal point. Okay. So, directly we have to take 432 by 24. Cancel the values. Actually, 3 table easily we have to cancel. 3 8s are, 3 1s are 3, balance 1, 3 4s are 12, balance 1, again 3 4s are 12. Okay. Now, 8 1s are 8, balance 664, 8 8s are 64. So, the answer is 18 kilometer. Okay.